on today's menu. We're gonna have a little bit of leftover rice from yesterday, some sausage, Smithfield sausage, mushrooms, yellow peppers, eggs. I'm just gonna make a little omelet out of that into this thing, and we're gonna have some coffee. And who's waiting for breakfast? She's waiting for breakfast. First, we'll start cooking down the sausage. You want to break it down to kind of like ground beef. Add some salt. And pepper.
Tengo la grabando.
Cayenne. Some paprika. And mix. Yellow peppers and mushroom. As this cooks, this coffee smells so good. And we mix. Let all the flavors marry together. So good. You become a coffee master here with the percolator.
Yes, first time trying the percolator.
She makes really good coffee.
We usually used to do the one in coconut oil.
The bulletproof.
We used to blend that with coconut oil. It tastes good too. Give it a lot of energy. And then we use the French press, the Cuban, of course.
First time using the
percolator. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, this is our first time using the percolator during this trip.
Well,
I mean, this is the first time ever.
Yeah, we've never used the percolator before, and let me tell you what, she's made some really good coffee with that percolator. And here's the breakfast. Now we'll add the rice. Bear with me, guys. I'm doing this one-handed. My camera operator is busy feeding these guys. Hey, quiet down. Now that we added the rice, just mix a little bit to get it warmed up because the rice is already cooked, and that rice is spicy because it has already some jalapenos in it and some other spices. This is what we ate last night. Looking good. Good morning, everybody. I guess it's time for breakfast. What do you say?
It's been time for breakfast 2 hours ago.
It's been time for breakfast over 2 hours ago. She's starving, so I guess it's time for breakfast. All right, let's get to it. Thank you.
beans hash.
I don't know what I invented here, but it's gonna work because we're hungry, right?
Everything that is in there, I like it, so that's a plus.
Take a look at that.
Gotta cover it.
Now we cover and let it simmer for about 10 minutes and see if how it...
No, 10 minutes is too long.
I'm gonna take the time now.
It's not gonna be 10 minutes.
Let me just stop.
Okay.
Alright, now that the eggs are in, we're gonna cover and let it sit until the eggs are semi-soft. That's it. We'll get back to you as soon as they're semi-soft. Hey, Andrea. See how the eggs are going? We're getting there. Alright, so it's been about 10 minutes. Let's see how it looks. Ready?
Here we go.
They just perfect, eh?
Yep.
Time to eat. Just a little something that I whipped up with the ingredients that I had from the night before. The rice has little hard pieces because when you cook it, it gets hard. Us Cubans, we call it rapa. I love rapa actually, so to me, it's really good. If you don't want that, I would suggest cooking the eggs in a different pot and just placing them over. Otherwise, this meal is awesome. All right, so now we're gonna head on over to the Cliff Dwellings in Manitowoc Springs. Welcome to the Manitowoc Springs Cliff Dwellings. The 40-room site was originally located in McElmo Canyon, which is in the southwest corner of Colorado near Mesa Verde and Dolores. The process of relocating these cliff dwellings began in 1904 and was completed in 1907. Virginia McClurg,
The original founder of the Colorado Cliff Dwellers Association hired William Crosby and the Manitou Cliff Dwellings Ruins Company to begin this process. They wanted to preserve and protect these dwellings from looters and relic pot hunters. Right now, what you're seeing is the part of the museum of the Manitou and Cliff Dwellings. We really liked how they set up everything to reimagine how life was as a Native American. Throughout the museum, you can see a lot of different artifacts that I consider artwork. I can understand why they wanted to preserve all this beautiful artwork. It would be a shame to lose all this artwork to looters and not be able to see it for generations. These artifacts are from the Mogollon tribe. These tribe were considered one of the first of southern New Mexico and Arizona area. It's really interesting to see how the process works. Of course, this is a reimagination of what it was. As you can see here, the yucca or the yucca tree is a very important plant in these tribes. They used to make sandals, robes, and even clothing. But not only that, this tree was also edible. This museum is really nice. It's giving you a glimpse of what Pueblo life was. This was cool to see. This was a timeline of ads that were done in the cliff dwellings. Check out these skulls. These are real skulls, and look at the different size. One is from the Cheyenne and the other one is from the Cliff Dwellers. This was a remarkable museum where we were able to see dioramas depicting daily life, exhibits of tools, potteries, weapons, and informative videos. This offers a glimpse of the mysterious peoples who left the remarkable architectural legacy on Mesa Tops and the Cliff Dwellings, like the ones you see here at Manitou Cliff Dwellings. I really recommend this place. Come see it. You'll definitely enjoy it. Now we're going to go ahead and check out the actual cliff dwellings here in Manitou Springs. These authentic cliff dwellings were first opened to the public in 1907. Since then, they have taken great care to preserve them so that generations of visitors can travel through time to experience a great American society, now long gone. As you can see, Lola got lazy on us, and luckily we're prepared and we have a backpack just for these cases. Such a cool view from up there, and I'll tell you what, this is a really nice location. Check out this view. You can literally spend the whole day out here. You will not get bored. This place has so much to do, so much to see, and so much history. This is not a recreation. This is a real thing, actually. They had to transport it from all the way in the Mesa Valley to here. It's amazing, and it's well built, and it fits really nice in this area. So get your butts out here and check this place out. What's really nice about this is that you're able to walk through this cliff dwellings and see every little crevice that it has. Like this here, seems like it was like a food storage of some type. Keep it cool, keep it away from animals. Each room has a purpose, and what's nice is that this is a self-guided tour, so you're able to follow along by numbers. It'll give you a little bit more information on an app you can download on your phone. I don't know if you guys just heard Andrea, she just mentioned that it's colder inside. Well, because of the rock formation, it's a lot cooler inside, so it makes it a great place to cool down, if anything, because it was hot that day. What Andrea is talking about is the speakers throughout the cliff dwellings. It gives a story of the Pueblo people and how they lived in the cliff dwellings. Here we have what is known as a kiva. Kiva is a Hopi word. They were often round, underground rooms and tended to be small household kivas that were used for a mix of routine and special purposes, such as a place to hold ceremonies. Here's a better idea of what the kiva looks like and how it's used. Hopis believed that the world before this one was destroyed, but a few chosen people were saved, climbing a ladder out of the smoky kiva and through the roof into the courtyard after ceremonies may have served as a powerful reminder of their movement from the world before. pretty amazing how these structures are built. It must have taken some great ingenuity to keep these places cool during the hot summer days. Here's that view again. I really can't get enough of this view. Look at that. Look at that beautiful mountain range. It's gorgeous. What an amazing structure. Look how tall this is. And take a look at these guys. They're amazing as well. Can't forget about Luna. She's also done an amazing job going up and down these structures. Come to think of it, I think she's really enjoying it. She's always checking out these little crevices around. So I think we enjoyed as much as the dogs did as well. We hope you enjoyed this episode. Please check us out on our next episode where we're going to check out the Bar Trail. Also, check us out on our social media platforms, which is Instagram and Facebook. And if you liked our video, hit that thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't. Share with your friends. Come join us on our adventures. We are Culture, Lifestyle, Travel.